To model uncertainty, it is sufficient to keep track of two ingredients. As a reminder, whenever we model uncertainty, we will assume that there is an underlying experiment of interest. So, the first ingredient we will keep track of is the set of all possible outcomes of the experiment. This set is called the sample space, and it is denoted by the Greek letter omega. Going back to our coin flipping example, the sample space in that case consisted of two items, heads and tails, because those are the only two possible outcomes to flipping a coin. The second ingredient we will keep track of is the probability of each possible outcome. And we will denote probability using a P with two vertical lines. Okay, so in the coin flipping case, we have, for a fair coin, we have probability of heads equals 1/2, and the probability of tails is also equal to 1/2. Okay? In general, in this class, we will use P of S to mean the probability of S happening. Okay, such as the probability of heads happening. So, these two ingredients, it turns out that it takes one ingredient to code this up in Python. We can store those two things with just a Python dictionary. So we can write model equals, so first the string heads, which we assign the value of 1/2, and then the string tails, which we also assign the value of 1/2. Okay, and so we can figure out what the sample space is by just looking at the keys of the dictionary. Okay, so the sample space is going to be the, I'm going to do the set of the of model.keys. Okay, the reason why I have set outside is because if you just do model.keys, it'll actually return a type that's not a Python set. It's going to be a set of dictionary keys, which is its own type. But to turn that into a set, you can just do set outside. Okay, so this gives you the sample space. Of course, if you want to figure out what the probability assigned, you can just look at what the dictionary evaluated at each of the keys are. So for example, model of heads stores 1/2, and model of tails also stores 1/2. Okay? Just a few important notes. So the first thing is that the sample space is what's called collectively exhaustive. Okay, so what this means is that every possible outcome is in omega. Okay, so every possible outcome is in omega, and also after running the experiment, okay, so after experiment is run, exactly one outcome happens. Okay, so So if you remember from the coin flip example where we had heads and tails, after you flip the coin, exactly one of these happens. You don't have like, oh, none of these happens, or like both of these happen. It's exactly one of these happens. Other important note is, of course, that the probabilities that are assigned are each between 0 and 1, right? So probabilities are each at least 0, at most 1. And the last very important thing is that the probabilities of all the outcomes have to sum to 1. Okay, probability of all outcomes need to sum to 1. So, if you remember, we had probability of heads plus probability of tails. Each of these was one half, and this added to 1. Okay?